Interesting. Voter fraud, absolutely. A man who voted for Trump decided to vote for Trump again using his wife's name, who he was arrested for murdering. I kid you not. Put up the pictures for mass here. Okay, so this person, this male that you see in the picture, he has been found guilty of voter fraud. Here's what he did. Let's keep his picture up. You see the woman next to him? He decided to cast a ballot for Donald Trump in her name. Here's the problem. She's been missing for a couple of years. Not only that, he was arrested for her murder. And the arrest was dropped, kicked out of court because of a discovery issue back and forth between the attorneys. The prosecution maintains he's the guy who killed his wife, but there is nobody. So technically, she is still missing. So while he's grieving his missing wife, he decides to use her name and engage in voter fraud to vote for Donald Trump twice. Colorado man who had been charged in the presumed death of his missing wife pleaded guilty to forgery for casting her 2020 election ballot for then President Donald Trump. Barry Morphew is his name. He pleaded guilty on Thursday and was fined and assessed a court cost of $600, according to the Denver Post. He avoids jail time as part of the plea agreement. Now, I want to highlight right here how democracy really isn't that important to many, okay? If democracy was really important, election workers, if anyone did violence against an election worker, it would basically be a hate crime. You would have serious protocols rather than these political narratives to protect democracy. And if somebody violated the law and attempted or successfully manipulated democracy, they will get more than a $600 fine. Okay, there's more. Suzanne Morphew was reported missing on Mother's Day in 2020. That's the wife that prosecutors say he killed. After she did not return from a bike ride near a home in Southern Colorado, Barry Morphew, who pleaded for help finding his wife, was arrested and charged with first degree murder and other crimes in 2021, but prosecutors dropped the charges in April. In the voter fraud case, investigators say Barry Morphew filled out his missing wife's ballot because, according to him, he thought Trump could use the extra vote. Trump lost Colorado to President Joe Biden by 14%. You have to imagine all of this voter fraud that's actually substantiated. There's proof, people are admitting to it, and it is overwhelmingly Trump supporters. You have to imagine the government has not caught all of it. I submit to you that the government may not have even caught half of the voter fraud that took place as people are voting for Donald Trump. These are folks that were caught. I think he was caught because this case was so high profile. There's more. Just because I wanted Trump to win, this is what he said. I thought, give him another vote. I figured all these other guys are cheating. You see, that is the most white privileged statement I've ever heard in my life. This man literally has said, because the other people are cheating, and he doesn't agree with cheating, he thinks cheating is wrong, he needs to now engage in voter fraud, because to a Trump supporter, that makes perfect sense. All right. So he says he did it. It was another vote. He didn't think anything was wrong with it. He told an FBI agent who confronted him about the ballot in April 2021. According to court documents, Morphew also told the agent he did not know it was illegal to fill out a ballot on behalf of a spouse. That's what the man said. All right? Okay. Adrienne, thoughts here.
Well, you know, it is, I think it's so interesting how the man has this mentality of everyone's doing it. Because in my research for my book, when it comes to misconduct and people engaging in behavior that they know is bad, people who engage in like this serial mentality, they think everyone is doing it. And that's the mentality of this person, which tells you this isn't the only misconduct he engages in, that he's probably a pretty shady person. And you know, it would be really nice if maybe the law started treating people in some kind of almost uniform way to the seriousness and the gravity and the sanctity of the type of offenses that they're committing. Because again, if we do care about democracy when it comes to voting, number one, we definitely have access for everyone to vote and having a day off, making it a federal holiday. But in addition to that, we'd actually make the penalties a lot steeper, because it definitely seems to me that it's Trump people who are, you know, taking advantage of this whole voter fraud thing.
Yeah, well said.